Hello friends, welcome back to our YouTube channel DS Tech Meetup. Topic for today's video is how to create a conference room booking app using Power Apps. Before starting with the actual development, I would like to give you a brief about a Power App which we are going to create. In this Power App, there will be 5 screens. First screen will be called main screen. Second screen will be meeting screen. Third, room select screen. Fourth, confirmation screen. And fifth will be book for unplanned meeting. So basically, using this app, you can book rooms for a planned meeting and for unplanned meeting as well. So in the first screen, which we will call main screen, there will be two buttons. One to book a room for a planned meeting and another to book a room for unplanned meeting. The screen type for this screen will be blank screen. The second screen, which will be meeting screen, the screen type of the second screen will be calendar screen, and in this screen we'll get to see all the meetings for a selected duration for a selected day. In the third screen, we will show all the rooms available for that particular duration, and using that screen you can select your room. Fourth will be the confirmation screen, you will get the confirmation message, and fifth will be the book for unplanned meeting. In using this screen, you can book a conference room for an unplanned meeting. So guys, if you are new to Power Apps, just don't get confused. The moment we'll start with the development, all the confusions, all the concepts will get clear. These are the few functions which I am going to use in my Power App. So I'm not going to cover them now. The reason I have created a slide for this function, so that at the end of this video, we are going to go through these two slides, and then we'll see what all Power App function we have covered in this video, and kind of it will give us a cover to understand how much we have learned. Before starting with the actual development, I would like to make one thing clear. The agenda of this video is not to create a conference room booking app, full-fledged room booking app. The agenda is to learn Power App basics, Power App concept through hands-on purpose. So yeah, there will be flaws in this video, there will be many functionality would be missing in this video, but definitely we are going to learn many good concepts of the Power Apps. So let's get started. So this is my Office 365 portal for the Power App. I'll click on this Power App icon from the left. It will take me to the Power App screen. Now I'm going to create a Canvas app. So from the left navigation, I will click on create Canvas app from blank. Name I will give DS Conference Room. Format I will select tablet. I'll click on create, and then it will create a blank Canvas app for us, in which we will create our conference room booking app. So this is my app. From here I'll start the development now. So guys, as I told you, there will be 5 screens. So let's go forward and create the first screen. So I will name my first screen as main screen. So I will right click over here. So before starting with the development, I will give you a very brief idea of this Canvas app if you are new to it. So in the left over here, you can see automatically I got one screen, which is blank screen. So in this screen, I can insert more controls at the top. In the ribbon, you can see insert button, and over here I have the option to insert some more new screen, which I will do as we progress with the development. There are various other control as well, like label, button, text, galleries, and I'm going to explain you each and every control the moment I will use in my development. In the left also, you can see over here there are data, media, and some advanced tool. In the data, if I click on add data, you can see various other entities and various connectors over here. So what I will do, I will explain you each and everything as I will use it. Okay, so I will start with the first screen. I will click on tree view. This is my first screen. I will right click on it. I'll rename it as main screen. And now in the left, you can see in the property section, I'm getting an option, three options: fill, background image, and image position. If I click on fill, I have the option to give the background color. If I select any color, I can set the background color for this screen, but for this app I will keep it as white because I'm gonna use a background image. Second option, this background image. For that, now I have to add an image file. So I have just browsed an image using the control over here and an image file. So this is the image file which I am going to use as the background image for this particular screen. Now image position, I will make it as fill, just to fill all the white space. So this is my screen. At the bottom I can, you know, zoom my screen. So this is my screen. And now as a next step, what I want to do, I want to, you know, just give a blur effect to this particular screen. For that I will add one rectangle over here. So what I will do, I'll click on this screen and I'll go to insert, and over here let me search. So rectangle is available under icon. So just select your screen, click on insert button, and then under icons you can see the rectangle over here. Just scroll down and you can see over here rectangle. So I will double click on it, and this is available inside my main screen. So what I will do, I will select it. Now I want to set the background color for this particular rectangle. Let me select it as white. No, I want to make it transparent. So for this rectangle I want to give a color so that, you know, it can give the dull effect to our background screen. For that let me do one thing. So I have selected this color, I'll go to the custom one. Over here you can see RGB, and this is for the opacity. So let me try one thing. Right now this is 100%. So you can see over here, if I'll make it 0, my rectangle will become transparent, entirely transparent. So let me increase it to 50. So over here you can see it is giving me a dull effect. So let me just, you know, put it on the entire screen, and then it will help me to decide further. So this is how my screen is looking. This is because of the blue color. So let me try now and change the color to this one. It's not working. Okay, let me go back. Over here this is simply because again opacity got increased to 100. So let me first select the color. I will select this color. I'll go back over here and I'll make it 50. So just remember guys, to make the area and to make the this box under A as 50%, or based on your requirement to give the dull effect. Now to me it looks good. So also, you know, if you are working on any real-time app, so with the increasing screens, with the, you will put more and more screens under screen, there will be multiple controls, and you know, in case of any maintenance or in case of any small CR, it might become difficult to recognize the controls. So it would be better if you could rename your controls immediately the moment you add them into your app, and you know, you can give them meaningful name. So what I'll say rectangle dull background. So I know now this control is a rectangle and I'm using it just to give a dull background. So my screen is fine. Now I told you this is my main screen. Using this screen I will give two functionality. One, to book a room for a planned meeting. Another, to book a room for unplanned meeting. For that I will use two buttons. So now I'll go forward and insert two button. Again I'm already under insert tab. I have to enter button. I'll click on button and another button. So I've got my two buttons. These are my buttons. If you face any difficulty in any selecting any control from here, just select them from your left navigation. This is my first button, this is my second one, and now I can move it easily. So first button, BTN, book room for planned meeting, and rename BTN book room for unplanned meeting. So these are my two controls. Now I'll drop them into the center of the page, and let me, you know, make changes. Let me make some changes in the properties. First of all, I'll increase their sizes. First of all, you know, my favorite property for the button is the border radius. I'll select this button from here, and I'll go in the right section under properties. I'll look for this border radius. I'll make it 80. Just give a, you know, I like this curve buttons, or I can try to give it, you know, 50 for the border radius. and then I can see how my button will look like. So this is fine. And same for this second button. This also I'll make as 50. And then I'll change the text. First of all, text would be book for planned meeting. I'll increase the width of the button. Yes. And book for unplanned meeting. Guys, Power App is very useful and very powerful. In few minutes, you know, the entire screen is ready. And you can imagine, if we are going to develop this screen using some code like .NET, it will take more time than it is taking now for us to build this app. So over here, you can see how useful are Power Apps, and you must learn them, as this is an emerging technology, or you can say emerging product from the Microsoft. So again, I'll change the border radius. I think it is fine. Then let me see for this plan meeting. So both are fine, is because of the width. We'll make them equal. So these are two buttons. I'll change their position. We will place them at a appropriate place so that they look good on the screen. And also maybe we can change the background button, background color for these two particular buttons. So this is my button, book for plan meeting. And let me increase the size of the button first, and okay, also let me increase the size. So let me read the configuration for this particular button. It's 418136. I'll replicate on it, 418136. And from here also you can use this right navigation section under properties. It is very useful. You can see various common properties are available over here for the button: text, display mode, visible, position. Position means the position as compared to the background screen. So if I move the position for this particular button, you can see the value for the position will change. So this is relative to your screen. So these two are my buttons. Also, I would like to increase the font size for the background text. So again, I will select my button and I will try to find the font. So font size, I'll say instead of 15, let's try to make it 20 and see. So 20 is quite looking good. It's looking more readable. Same for the another button. So 20. So now these are my two button. Let me just try and play with the background color for the buttons. Okay, let me just quickly correct the spelling for the plan, although it is not important, but I just caught it, so thought of changing it. Right. Yeah. So let's try with some other background color. This is my favorite one. Okay. I'll go with my favorite color. And this is my favorite color in Power Apps. Okay. Fine. So this is how my main screen is looked like now. And with just last minute, some cosmetic changes. And for this particular demo, this screen will be final. Just change the text for this one. Book for unplanned meeting. Book for unplanned meeting. As I told you, the main agenda, main motive of this video is not to create an app, is to learn Power App concepts through a hands-on purpose, through hands-on. So these are two buttons. So our first screen is ready, and you can see in few minutes we are able to build a Power App screen. So what we did, we create a Power App Converse app. By default, we got a screen. I renamed this screen. This was a blank screen. I renamed this screen main screen. I inserted three controls, two buttons, and then one rectangle just to give a blur effect to the background. And then I set the background image for this particular screen. We have other options also. We can set the background color as well, so that you can decide on your own what it's suiting more with your requirement. So guys, our first screen is ready, and now we'll go forward and work on the other screens. So as I told you, we will create 5 screens. So now I will create the second screen. The second screen will be meeting screen, and it will be of type calendar screen. What this screen will do, this screen will fetch all the meetings set in my calendar. So guys, I already set up few meetings in my calendar just for this particular demo. But as you, I think, I'm assuming that all of you must be aware how to set up a meeting in your Outlook calendar. It's very simple. So just set up some sample meetings, and our calendar screen will automatically pull all the meetings. So go forward and create second screen. Now, how to add a new screen to your app? at the top in the ribbon, you can see this option new screen. I will click on it and I can see multiple options over here, multiple screen types, blank, scrollable, list, success, tutorial. But in this demo, I will cover blank screen and another would be calendar screen. So I will use these two screens and I will try to cover other screens in some other demos. So I'll click on calendar screen. So immediately my first step would be to rename my screen. I'll say meeting screen. So guys, you can see automatically this screen came up with many controls. So these are the capabilities of the Power App. You can see it comes with inbuilt screen, which can be very useful. You can directly plug them in your app and you can straight away use them and create very useful, very powerful app, which can be very handy in your day-to-day office environment. So now we'll go forward with this meeting screen. So in this meeting screen, I can see calendar. And over here, if I expand it, I'll see this calendar event gallery. So this is another gallery. I will cover this. And so let's see what this calendar screen is giving us. So now to play your screen or to run your Power App, there are two options. First, at the top, you can see this play button. You can click on it and you can see now you can run your app, you can test your app. So I'll select the calendar. So automatically it is loading the events in my from my Outlook. So there is a planned meeting and the name of the meeting is the unplanned meeting. Otherwise it's a meeting from my Outlook. And you can see if I select another date, so with all these dates, a meeting is already available. And you can see there are other controls as well, other drop down values like birthday and United States holidays, which I won't be covering in this video. So my focus will be on the calendar and then I'll work with this drop down. So I will do one more thing. I will go to my Outlook and I will try to add few more meetings for this demo, so that you can see how this gallery control is also useful. So let me go to the Outlook and add few more meetings for this demo. So I'll select from here, I'll go to the Outlook. So friends, I've added few meetings from my Outlook and now let's see, this calendar should pull those meetings and display in our app. So let's go first and run the app again, then only it will refresh. This is my app. I will use this drop down. I'll select calendar and you can see multiple meetings are now appearing. So now I'll explain you the gallery control over here, which is inbuilt in the meeting screen. So you can see this is the gallery control. So this control is being used if you want to display multiple things for the same occurrence. Like I want to display the meeting available in my calendar. So this particular row is going to repeat for each and every meeting with the same look and feel. So for those purpose, I will use the gallery control. So over here, you can see multiple gallery controls are available, vertical, horizontal. So we will cover them in a separate video. So over here, you can just understand, like if I want to add one button, if I'll add one button for this particular row, it will appear in all the rows. If whatever the changes I'll make in any row, it will be same for all the rows. So in short, this is the gallery control. So now you can see this gallery control is pulling all the meetings from my Outlook. At 2 o'clock, I have DS Tech Mirror demo for 60 minutes. At 4 o'clock, I have an unplanned meeting. At 6 o'clock, I have Power App demo for 60 minutes. So this is appearing for these two meetings. There is no room booked. And for this meeting, there's a room booked called Ganga. Now, before proceeding further, one more thing I would like to cover. If you're trying this app in your trial Office 365 environment, there's a good possibility that there won't be any room available in your Outlook. So if you want to add rooms in your Outlook, how you can do that? Just go to your Office 365 using link portal.office.com. Then from the left, go to the admin center. From there, click on show all. And then over here, you can see this link resources. Expand this. And over here, you can see rooms and equipment. Now, if you want to add any room in your Outlook, You can do it from here or any other resource. You can see these are the 5 rooms available in my environment: Alaknanda, Brahmaputra, Ganga, Satluj, Yamuna. If I want to add another room, I'll click on add resource. Resource type would be room or equipment. I will say room. I'll give the name for the room like XYZ. Email, I can give it on my own. Capacity, I will select, let's say 45. Location, I can leave. Phone number, my wish. And then I'll click on save. After that, this room is not going to available immediately in your Outlook. If you immediately save it and you will move to your Outlook and try to book this room, it will not be available, at least for me. I don't know about yours, but it took around 24 hours to, you know, to get it synchronized with the Outlook. So the moment I add these rooms, the next day only they were appearing in my Outlook. So this is just one thing which I want to make it clear so that you don't get troubled looking at your Outlook and then see how you can add a room. So if you are trying this demo at your end, so and it's your trial environment, so just add your rooms beforehand from using these steps and just wait for some time to get it synchronized with your Outlook. So let's go back to the app once again. So this is our app. So I was saying, so now this screen is ready because automatically everything we got ready. So now what I will do, I'll just plug one button over here to book a room. So now what user will do, user will come over here, user will say, okay, I want to book a room for my 2 o'clock meeting. So one button should be available over here. So now I want to add a button. Now one thing you should see over here, if I want to add a button over here, I'll click on meeting screen, okay, I'll select button, okay. Now I want to plug this button into my gallery over here, and you can see I plug the button in this over here. Now I'll play, but this button is not available with other rows. It was just available over here. So at runtime, I don't know how many meetings would be available for me. So this is not the right way. So what I have to do, this is just for the gallery controls. If I want to add anything in the gallery, just select your gallery. And then you can see the edit button over here. Just click on it. And now I will add a button. And you can see automatically it is available for all the items in my gallery. Now I will move this button to the right. And automatically it will reflect for all the controls, sorry, for all the items in my gallery. So guys, this is important. If you want to add any control in your gallery, just select your screen, then select your gallery, click on this add icon and just add your control. Now I'll rename this button. I'll say book, simple, and automatically it reflects for all the other items as well. Now, one more thing I would like to do, I'll change the background color just to give some sort of consistency with my main screen. Over here, we select this button. So same, I would like to do over here also. So what I'll do, I'll just select this one and then I'll try to see this is label app name 1. So over here, I'll select over here label app name 1. I will try and see which control this is in my left. And over here it is label app. So I will go here and try to change the background color. So this is my background color, okay, and still, because you know this was my label app name 1 and it was not the background, this background. So again I'll select this background. This was rectangle quick action bar 1. I'll select the background color for this also. So now this is fine. I'll change the background color for these buttons as well. This is very simple. Just select the button, go to your right section, color, click on it and select your color. So guys, my next screen is also ready. Meeting screen is ready. Now, I want to make some changes. First of all, I want to connect these two screens. Now, if I am on the screen, I'll click on book for planned meeting. Nothing is happening. So now I want user to navigate. The moment user click on book for planned meeting, my app should navigate to the meeting screen. How I'm gonna do that? For that, I'll select this button over here. Now I told you at the top, let me select this button. Now you can see from here, I don't know why I'm finding it difficult to select this button. So if you're facing the same issue, just select from the left menu, book for plan meeting. Now I told you insert some controls are available, and under that over here you can see various events. So on this button there are various events, border color, border style, few of which are available from the right also, properties section. So guys, these are properties, these are the same properties which are appearing in your right section. You can select from here also, because let me just show you. You selected this color from here, you can see. So from here I'll select my function for this particular button. I will select this one event called onSelect. There are various other events as well, like focus, hide, border, hover, onSelect. For now we will focus on onSelect event. I'll select onSelect. Right now value is false. I will remove it. And now over here I will use PowerApp functions, which I have mentioned in my slides as well. So all these functions we are going to use in this PowerApp, and at the end of this video you will have a very good idea about PowerApp function using which you can do the development in your PowerApp. So first function is the navigate. Using this function you can navigate between different screens in your PowerApp. So I'll select book for plan meeting and then say navigate. And then at the top you can see it is asking me for the parameter. Parameter is the target screen. So I'll say target screen, and at the bottom it is giving me an option. I'll say meeting screen. I want to navigate to meeting screen. Then I'll say comma. The second option, it is asking for some transition. Just the hover effect. Just the moment you will move to this screen, it will ask for some animation. I'll say cover right. And then I'll close it, and I'm done with it. So I'm able to connect my PowerApp. I'm able to connect my main screen with the meeting screen. So now I can click on play button and test it. This is one way. Also, there's another way. Just press Alt button in from your keyboard, and you can, you know, they will be available to test from here only. Without selecting the Alt button, it will be in edit mode. The moment I'll press the Alt button, it will be in play mode, run mode. So I'll say book for plan meeting, and you can see I'm getting navigated to the meeting screen. So guys, this is done. This is how we can navigate. So we have covered one function. From here you can see navigate. Okay, so let's go, and few more things I will do from here in this meeting screen. I have inserted the book button. Okay, this another thing. I'm clicking on Alt button, and you can see I can select the future dates. It is showing me all these meetings because my calendar will be same for the Feb month. The moment I'll move to March, see, it is changing. It is updating the meetings for those respective dates. But right now there's one flaw. I can select the past dates as well. So I want to make sure that user should not be able to select past date. User should be able to select the current date only. And how we can do that? Again, I will be using PowerApp function. So this is a bit tricky. So please focus. Now friends, just to make the past dates unavailable, what I'm going to do, I'll just give some different color effect to the past date, and I will make them unselectable. So for that, what I will do, as I told you, see, I have to work on these dates. So the moment I'm clicking on it, it's a gallery. You can see it's a gallery, and in the left I can see it's a month gallery. So I will expand it, and inside this I can see there are three controls. So title, okay, so I have to work with this date, subcircle, okay, and circle. So I will work with this one, with the title too. And now what I have to do, I have to change the color for the past dates which are less than today. For that, what I will do, I will work with this color function over here. You can see, so automatically this is the code which is written over here in our calendar, sorry, in our meeting screen. So automatically this is the code because of which this is the functionality we are getting. So it is saying if date add first day in view comma this dot this item dot value. So date add is another function. What it will do, it will add some unit to your date. So first I will explain you each and everything, just don't get confused. So just try to explain in small chunks. This is one condition. This is condition till here, if equal to this. So now if this is true, this is gonna happen, and if false, this is gonna happen. So there are two conditions over here, you can see. Click on over here, and over here my if condition is getting ended. So what I will do, I will remove this entire condition and I will, you know, insert my on formula over here to achieve the effect which I want. Just to give you a basic understanding of the if condition, how it works. This is my condition equal to this. This after comma, this is, this will work if my if condition is true, and if it is false, then it will work. It will see this, and again there's a condition, so it is kind of a nested if. Okay, so now don't get confused, because I will write a formula over here and then we will see how it will work. So what I'll say, and one more thing, just to make you understand of this first day in view what it is and this item dot value, because I'm also gonna use this. So let me just remove this entire formula first. Okay, let me remove everything. So I'll say if first day in view, say first day, I'm getting the intelligence at the bottom, first day in view, if underscore first day in view comma this item dot value, the same it was earlier. I will explain you. Let me write the formula first. This item dot value. Okay, so this is my if condition, and what I will do, I want to first of all, sorry guys, I will write it again, because otherwise it will lead to a confusion. So if I want to use date add function, what it will do, I will explain you. Over here you can see some inputs for the date add. You can see date add, it is asking for the date. So I will provide the date underscore first day in view. Then it is asking for the number of units comma number of units, a number of units to add. This number can be negative as well. My number will be this item dot value. This is fine. Now this is my first. Now less than today, this is my if condition. Now if the first part is less than today, if this is true, then color should be, color fade should be there. Color fade, this is for the past days time using. So I will use color fade function, and it should be like anything. You can say RGBA, and then you can write the color like 80 comma 80 comma 80, and after that you have to write the, you know, RGB and comma, it will be fade. By how much percentage it should get fade? So I'll say my 80% fade the color. So this is my first part. After that, now I have to write the else condition, otherwise color should be RGBA 80 comma 80 comma 80. So these are two my conditions. First of all, let me, you know, figure out what is the error, and then I will explain you. Invalid number of arguments, received 3, expected 4. Okay, so this is my color fade function, RGBA 80 80 80 comma 80%. Fine, this is fine. Somewhere maybe I am missing the brackets. Let me just see, because I can do this offline also, but I want to give you the real time feeling, how, what are the issues you will face when you will work with the Power App. So these are few small issues you will face. So, and you know, that's why I am fixing these issues right in front of you without pausing the video. So let me see how I can do. Over here, this is color fade, fine. This is my, let me start from the beginning. Okay, this is fine. The moment I am selecting this bracket, I can see over here, this is fine. Then date add function. Okay, this is closing over here, first day in view, this item dot value. Then less than, fine, less than today. Okay, after that color fade, I'm using this function color fade, where color fade is ending, color fade is ending over here. After that RGBA 80, 80. Okay, over here we have to see. Yes, I can see invalid number of arguments I'm getting. So let's see, it is expecting the fourth one. What it is, give it. Okay, the alpha value component I was missing. So this is, you can see red value, green value, blue value and the alpha value, and then the percentage, same over here. So I was missing the one argument, so this is also fine. So now my formula is fine and you can see the effect over here immediately. So let me just save my app. I'll say save the cloud. So you could see the, you know, immediate result over here. So let me just show you and then I'll come back to this formula. Let me play. I'll click on play button and you can see the, although I can select this date, but now they have a blur effect. Before, you know, disabling the on select for this, I will explain you this formula. And for explaining, you know, first of all, these two values should be clear to us. The best way to understand what is in these value, just select on this. And over here you can see I'm getting this date 31st 2021, the first day in view, and it, that means this date. If I move to the next month, if I say March, what is the first? And again I'll go back to our formula. You can see over here we have to go to color. First of all, I have to select this title. Okay, and then I'll say for double click, I have to double click on it. I can see this date. So I understood this is first day in view. Now what is this item dot value? I'll select this item dot value. If I double click on it, I'm not getting. If I double click on it also, I'm not getting anything. So what would be the best way to understand what is there present inside this item dot value? What I will do, simply I will select, I know this is for my gallery, simply I will select this gallery. I'll click on edit. I'll insert one label. Okay, so you can see this label got added over here at the top, 0 1 2 3. Okay, and this is the value over here for this label text, this item dot value. Now let me cut it. Nothing is available over here. Now let me type what is there, this item dot value. What I'm getting, this item dot value 0 1 2. So the date which you have selected, all those values are only available for them. Let me play over here. I'm getting this value 1 2 3. So guys, I've added this label and now I will understand what is the value for this item dot value. It is nothing but the date which you will select. So let me click on play, and over here you can see for the first value is 1 2 3 4. This is for the month of March. See, if the date is 22, value is 22. So guys, in our if, this date add function, what it is doing, it is nothing, it's just calculating the date for each date, like for first Feb, second Feb, it is calculating the date and it is comparing with the today's date. So for the first Feb is less than today's date, so color fade function is running, and for the dates like 15th and 16th, so it is false, so my second condition is working. So now you must be thinking how this is working, my date add function. So how, what value it is calculating if you want to understand. So for other things I have explained you, like first day in view, you can double click on it, you can see the value over here, it is getting this value. For the entire function, what it is returning, if you want to understand, simple is just add one label in your gallery and then simply replace the text value of the label with this function. So let's see, this is my gallery. I'll click on edit icon, I'll click on label, I got the label. And now what I will do, I'll select this one, date add, I will replace this one with this, and you can see the change over here. You can see if I'll play this, so this is my label. What it is doing nothing, it is simply calculating the dates, it is calculating the complete date and then comparing with the today's date. And how it is working, this is 31, and then for every date, like for the second date, 31 plus 2 will be coming as second Feb, 31 plus 3 third Feb, like that it is working. If I move forward, for the month of March. So over here I have to see what is there in the first day in view. So I'll go back. What is first day in view? First day is 28. So what it is doing, 28 plus like the first day, 28 plus 1, so it will become 1st March. 28 plus 2, automatically it is calculating my dateTime function. It knows my dateTime function is intelligent enough. It knows that this is the 28th Feb. So after that, if it will add two more units to it, automatically it will become 2nd March. So this is how we are calculating the date in my if condition. In my if condition for this particular title, for this control. So I am over here just comparing my date, and based on the result I am doing the color fade and normal color function. So this is how I am disabling the past date. And as a next step, over here you can see I can let me go back. Yes, so over here you can see all these past dates are disabled, but still I can select them. So I want to, you know, disable this select. Again, I will select this title. For this select, you know, I'll go to onSelect function. This is my onSelect function, and over here I will work on it. So what it is happening, what it is doing, set underscore date selected, date add. So this is my normal way. So it means this, if you are new to Power App and you don't want to get confused yourself, just keep it simple and understand on select this is happening for each and every day. Now you want to just disable this particular functionality. You want to just disable this particular functionality for the past date, right? So what I will do, I will do control X. So guys, what I will do now for this title control, I will write the condition for the on select so that end user should not be able to select any past date. It should, user should be able to select only present and future dates. So this title is just a label and it is inside our gallery. So what I will do, I will select it, and over here, so friend, this is the default value. I will just, you can see in this default value what we are doing, this is a variable, we are setting a variable. Set is the function which is used to set a variable, and it will create a global variable. So if a variable is present, it will set the value. Otherwise, a variable, global variable will be created, and this will be the value of the global variable, and this global variable we can use across our app. Its scope will be at the app level. So guys, you can see this is set function. I will come back to it again. Let me first write the function to disable the selection of the past date. So what I'll say if, I will use the if condition, and now I will calculate the today's date. The date which user will select from this calendar, I will calculate that date first. How we can do that? If date add, simply I will use date add function. In the date add, I'll say first day in view underscore, it will give me IntelliSense first day in view comma, and I will add the this selected date. I will add the selected date to it, this item dot value. Now this is my date. If it is greater than equal to today, now if this date is greater than equal to today, that means future dates, I'll say comma. After that, I will say comma. Now after comma, you have to write the condition. So if this condition is true, this set of actions will run. What is the first action? I'll say select parent. You just select the parent. So select parent means just select that date. And then there was one more action which was the default one. We will simply paste it without worrying about it. So this is my condition, you can say that, and I'm not providing any false condition for it. So I'm just providing the true condition. If this condition is true, these two steps will happen, and if this is false, nothing is happened. So this is fine. So this is how we are calculating the date. I'll save my Power App and then we'll see how it is working. And now you can see I cannot select my past dates because my date is old and this is not working for the past date. It is not going inside the if condition. It is only working for the future condition. Now let's see one more thing. Now if I remove this select parent, then what is the effect? Whether it will still work? You can say it is still working. So just to avoid any confusion, earlier I'll say Earlier, only this set of statement was there. So I simply put this set of statement inside the if condition that it should work only for the past date and the future. Sorry, only for the present date and the future date. Date at. So if you want to get the date from the calendar screen selected, date at first day in view, this item dot value. Now over here, you should have two questions. First one is, what is this first day in view, from where I'm getting it? And what is this set function? So guys, what is this first day in view? So you can see this is a meeting screen, like this is a calendar screen. So in this screen, if you will, you know, explore around it, there will be, you know, you can find an ample amount of code written to achieve this functionality. So by default, this variable is present in this screen. So I am just reusing it. So if you will, you know, if you will explore around it, you will see I'm just using the existing variable. So this variable was already existing, so I just used it. So this answers your first question about this first day in view. Second should be, what is set function? Now let me tell you the set function. This was my title, so let me just say, okay, yeah, so let me just remove the white space, otherwise yes. So this is set function. Set function is nothing. If you want to create a global variable in your Power App, use set function. What it do? First is the variable name, you can see, and the second is the value of the variable. So what we are doing, this was already present, underscore date selected, and we will give this value to my underscore date selected. So guys, this answers your both of your question. Now my meeting screen is also ready. So I am done with my meeting screen. If I'll go back to my PPT, over here you can see I have used navigate. I'll come back to back function later on. And then I have covered date add function. Somewhere I is over here you can see the date add function add a number of units to a date time value. We can use date add function with the time zone offset. This will convert local time to UTC. And subtracting it will convert UTC time to local time. So this is another use of date add function, which you can use to convert your UTC time to the local time and local time to the UTC time. And other part is, if you want to add any units to your date, so you can use date add functions. So these two functions I've used, date and another is this set function. Set function used to create global variable, and they will be available all over your app. So guys, this is what we have learned. Now in this screen, next screen would be to select your screen. So what will happen, the moment end user will click on book, it will take you to the third screen. What is your third screen? It is room select screen, and that will be a blank screen. So what I will do, I will simply select new screen, a blank screen, quickly rename it room select screen, and then on click of book button, on click of this, what should happen? I will use navigate function, which I have already covered, and its user should navigate to room select screen with any of the animated effect. So this is my navigation function. This is my navigate function. So guys, I am done with my main screen, meeting screen, and next will be my room select screen. So this is a most important screen of our app. In this screen, we will display all the rooms available for this meeting. Now my meeting is on 16th at 2 p.m. So at 2 p.m. all the available rooms, all the resources available should be display over here, so that user can book a room of his choice, his or her choice. So now this is very important screen, and there will be all the, you know, important logic we will write on this screen. So friends, room select screen I will cover in part 2 of this video. You can find the link in the description box below for the part 2 of this video. So guys, thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please like and share the video and subscribe to the channel for future notifications. If you face any issue, please reach out to us through our official email ID contact.dstechmirror@gmail.com. Also, you can join a group over Facebook called Modern SharePoint, and you can follow me on Twitter on my Twitter handle. So guys, thank you. Much love. Keep learning.